Yo, what's going on, guys? Welcome to this episode of Inside the Cut. And in today's episode, we're going through my University of Georgia concert recap with Snyder Music, 51B Music, and Bonnie and Clyde. Check it out.
Charlie McCall, the world's greatest cocktail party. Do you know what is going to happen here tonight? Boom, came apart. Man, is there going to be some property destroyed tonight? Dogs on top. We were gone.
So this was a super cool trip for me and Snyder. Playing at UGA was pretty big. It's an SEC school. It's a school that I've gone to a bunch of games at. Have always been a Georgia fan ever since I was a kid. So getting to go do a show here, perform, get to see the Greek life side of the university, which I'd never seen before, was super, super cool. And I think the video came out pretty cool. So let's jump in. The video really just kicks off with this clip of Snyder walking up to the stage from beside the house. So he's just walking, and every show we do, we try to do an intro clip, whether or not we're going to use it. It's essentially him just saying, you know, what's up to the university, shouting out any of the sponsors. In this case, the show was hooked up by BeatGig, so we shouted out BeatGig. So basically just walking up, getting the video started, we show the logos, then we have the logos drop down to the bottom left and right hand corner. So you see Snyder Music bottom left, BeatGig bottom right throughout the whole video. Then Snyder says a little swipe motion to the camera. We just did a really easy slide effect there. I mean, nothing too crazy. I actually ended up doing a mask. You can kind of see how that mask comes right across. So not that I really needed to, I probably could have just done like a slide transition, but it was super easy to do that. Just hit a few keyframes on it and rocked it. And then it immediately goes into a little slow motion clip of Snyder behind the deck, and then him talking to Bonnie and Clyde. What I really wanted to do right at the beginning of the video was just kind of show all the people that were involved in the show. So people who might know those names would be engaged through the rest of the video. So we showed Bonnie and Clyde talking. We showed them in front of the crowd taking a picture. Then we showed 51B, who is an artist that Snyder does a lot of music with. He's actually the artist that was in the song of Till Nothing's Left that I used on my Cuts recap video. This was actually, I think, their first performance together, and they performed a few of their songs that went pretty well after Snyder had opened up for a little bit. And then we show my logo, and then just go into a classic beat build with a lot of just clips stacked really fast as the music's going. And what was cool about this one is that the University of Georgia has like a famous announcer for a lot of their football games. His name's Larry Munson. So if you YouTube search Larry Munson, there's a lot of like classic calls that he's had on games, and I thought it'd be super cool to incorporate one of those into the video because there's kind of a lot of emotion in there. So the first one sounds a little bit like this, and I'll just play it without the music in the background. He said this, he says this game has always been called the world's greatest cocktail party.
Do you know what is going to happen here tonight?
And he says, do you know what's going to happen here tonight? So that's a clip actually before a University of Georgia versus Florida game. They call that game the world's largest cocktail party. So that was a really funny clip. And then the next one goes like this.
Boom, came apart. Man, is there going to be some property destroyed tonight?
So he says, man, there's going to be some property destroyed tonight, which is really funny. Kind of like plays into the whole party thing. And then he says something about
dogs on top, we were gone.
And the cool part is right after he says dogs on top, we were gone, the beat drops. So it goes
dogs on top, we were gone. And
once the beat drops, I started just kind of going into my to some other clips I had. The first clip that you see is actually not a great clip from a standpoint of it's not really in focus. It's kind of crazy with the camera movement, but the beat goes so crazy at the beginning that it ended up working out really well. So Snyder's just going wild, and I was going kind of crazy with the camera, and it really just kind of fit the beat pretty good. And then just a few other clips here of him throwing his hands up to the crowd, then stacked a few other ones. This is a really cool gimbal shot here, since we had enough production to where the stage was pretty big, and then there was a little pit between the stage and the crowd, so I was able to use my gimbal a lot and get some really clean shots. So this one came out super smooth. It kind of just faded right there. a quick, easy transition right into like a camera motion up. So I did just like a little cross dissolve, faded it into when the camera's coming up, and just what that did is it added some interesting motion into the transition beyond just a dissolve camera up, then into the next one. And it's just Snyder, you know, shaking and dancing. Then, you know, I've talked about this before in these, but like always trying to get different angles. Don't just do everything from the stage, do some stuff from the crowd, try to get a bunch of stuff so when you're either doing like builds or you're trying to stack a bunch of clips, you don't have the same look all the time. So I went to the back of the whole event. I had, I think a 60 or 70 millimeter lens that I put onto the Sony and was able to really get some crispy shots, but from behind. So that added some nice variety here. Stacked in a few more ones, just crowd stuff, more crowd stuff. On this one, I did like kind of that classic zoom tilt. You probably see that all the time in videos where it's just zooming and then rotating. So that was a nice one to put in there. This is a quick shot I did with a GoPro. I had a GoPro that I gave to the crowd for a little while. I said, you know, pass it around, do whatever. And the crowd was super into it. They had it for like 30, 40 minutes. And I ended up using like half a second of one of the clips just because the footage was pretty bad. And one of the fraternity guys actually had the camera pointed to his hand for most of it. So the footage actually didn't come out good at all, but got a little clip out of it, so I guess it works. Then another cool shot from behind. I got a wide one from behind, so I took off the 70, put on the wide, I think it was a 24, and then went from the back, from behind, had the cool lights going. This is when it started getting dark and the lights really showed well. Another one from behind, a cool little rotating shot here to Snyder behind the deck. Another gimbal shot, so you can kind of see we're flipping between light and day because Snyder's set started before the sun had gone down and he ended up having to play extra hours because Bonnie and Clyde were actually coming from Ultra Music Festival and they were delayed by like an hour or two. So instead of playing an hour, I think he played 3 hours until they got there. So we got a bunch more footage than we were expecting. He played for a lot longer, which is pretty crazy. Some more clips of that, another one of 51 dancing with the crowd, then another one from behind the deck too, just kind of a simple, you know, high up above. These are really good for photos. And then if the crowd packs out, it's always a cool angle because you can get most of the crowd into it and you can get the full production setup as well. That one just kind of does a quick zoom transition into another shot of the crowd. Just a quick little gimbal kind of, you know, side scroll there. Another one kind of just starting from the crowd. And what I did with this one is I just did like a fast forward into the shot behind them. So it kind of speeds up and then slows down, like technically a speed ramp there. So you see the crowd, then you see the crowd again, but it speed ramps down behind Snyder. And this is just kind of like the way that I end it. So it speed ramps and it slows down, cuts to another shot of him in front of the crowd, dancing around, has the social media handle pop up. Then just one more quick clip of him in a slow motion. I kind of like ending off with slow motion because usually with my edits, there's kind of the build up, then there's the beat drop, and then the beat drop usually goes and drops off again. So to kind of change with the energy, usually I'm going to start out slow motion, go normal pace, then cut up a lot of stuff on that build, have the normal space clips of everyone dancing, going wild, and then I'm going to slow down again. And I usually have the clips follow the same pace, whether it's slow motion or how quickly I'm cutting them. So ending with slow motion tends to just match the energy of that part of the song. So had that come in, fade the music out, and that's it. So it was a pretty quick little edit. I mean, honestly, it came together really quickly in my mind. Snyder gave me the song once again, and then once I had the ideas for the Larry Munson like play calls and announcing, it all came together really easily. I think I edited it in like 2 or 3 hours, actually on the drive back from Georgia. So I was sitting in the back seat with Snyder and his girlfriend, put it together, and we put it out, I think, the next day, and everyone thought it was pretty sick, especially all the UGA people, because the Larry Munson connection was just super cool, and had like a really close tie to the university. So just a cool way to customize the edit to where we shot it at. I think it came together super well, and now I'm going to show you guys what the full thing was like. Hope you guys enjoyed this episode of Inside the Cut, and I'll see y'all later. Peace.
Yo, what's good? DJ Snyder. I'm out here at University of Georgia. About to turn the f*** up. Special shout out to V-Gig for having me out.
Always been called the world's greatest cocktail party. Do you know what is going to happen here tonight? Boots came apart. Man, is there going to be some property destroyed tonight? Dogs on top. We were gone. Hey, this is incredible.